हेलो एवरीवन, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू प्रैक्टिस शीट नंबर 14, प्रोजेक्शंस ऑफ सॉलिड्स। अर्लियर टू शीट्स वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन सम एग्जांपल्स हाउ टू ड्रॉ द प्रोजेक्शंस ऑफ सॉलिड्स व्हेन दे आर इंक्लाइंड टू बोथ प्लेन्स। नाउ टुडेज एक्सरसाइज प्रॉब्लम नंबर 1, इट इज ऑन पेंटागोनल प्रिज्म। सो पेंटागोनल प्रिज्म, आई एम जस्ट रीडिंग द प्रॉब्लम विच इज हियर। पेंटागोनल प्रिज्म of 40 mm base edge and 80 mm height is resting on its base in VP and inclined to VP by 60 degrees. Draw the projections if the resting edge is in VP is inclined to HP by 70 degrees. Now see, the size of the pentagon is given, the prism is given. Now it is resting in VP on its edge. Now since it is resting in VP, we are drawing the position like this above XY line, because this background is VP. So the dimensions are, this is taken as 50 and this is taken as the height, that is in this case 80 mm. Then it says that the axis is inclined to VP by 60 degrees. So this axis is 60 degrees, that means the base is 30 degrees. So the axis is shown here 60 degrees, it is making with the VP. Then it says the edge on which it is resting. This is the edge on which it is resting. This edge is supposed to make 70 degrees to the HP. So now what we do is, first thing is the inclination to the VP. So for that, we draw these projections in the first initial position. Then we draw the axis at 60 degrees to HP, to VP, that means the base at 30 degrees. So we can draw the base at 30, so that axis will be automatically 60 degrees. So we draw this figure as a repeat figure, and from this and this figure, by projecting the points, we are drawing the revised front view in this step. Now once this front view is drawn, we have the resting edge which is perpendicular to HP at the moment. We want this resting edge to be inclined at 70 degrees to HP. So instead of 90 degrees, we have to rotate it and make it 70 degrees. That means the same figure is repeated here with this edge. This is the edge on which it is resting. You can see here. This is the edge on which it is resting. So that resting edge we are drawing at 70 degrees. So this line, if you extend, it is going to make 70 degree with the HP, means XY line. So this figure is drawn here as a repetition by inclining the resting edge at 70 degrees. Now once this is drawn, now we have to project this particular view down all the points, and also you have to project the points in this direction. Now when you do that, what we have to notice is, first thing is we have to name the points. So when you name the points here, maybe the base points are named as 1, 2, because we already decided the resting edge is going to be AB. So A, B, C, D, E. So this is going to be A, B, C, D and E. Then there is a top pentagonal surface also there. So that will be marked as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So A, B, C, D, E and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, they are the points which will be on the top surface. Now what we do, we are going to repeat the same point. So ABCD will be here and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will be here. Similarly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will be on this plane and ABCD will be on this plane, and it is resting on AB. So these point names are extremely important, because they are going to help us in preparing the figures. So having done this much, now we are going to project each and every point here. So you know this is line AB. So this is A and this is B. So that same A and B is here. A is here, B is here. Now you are going to project point A. So point A is in VP. Point A is in this position. So when you project it down, you will find this is the position of point A. So like that, B is here. So B must be on XY line. But in this case, B is here. That means it is here. So when you project, this is going to be your point B. So this line AB is this line AB on which it is resting. You can clearly see, it is resting on this edge AB. Now this edge AB is not seen here. It is seen as a point, because it is perpendicular to our direction of viewing. So we draw line AB. Now after we draw line AB, next thing is, we have to project the rest of the points. So by same method, if you project the points C, D and E, you will find these points will be at different positions. So when you project them, you will find them like this point, you will find here, this point you will find here, and this point. You will point here because this is the position of point these two. So these two points are here. So when they are here and they are here, and then the single point is here, which is here, which is here, which is here. So when you name the points, you will get all these points over here. Same thing you have to do for the top plane, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 here. So from this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and from this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you can get this pentagon. So after drawing this much, then we have to go for what is called as showing the lines which are dotted and which are continuous. Now as you see the figure which is like this, this is the top surface which is seen and this is the base that is not seen. So the edges which are on the base, they are not seen, and as a result, you will see that these three lines, 1, 2 and 3, these three lines will be dotted. At the moment they are not, but they are supposed to be dotted. So that we will draw. So just hold it. Okay, so you can see all the necessary modifications are done. This is the axis which is making 60 degrees and these are the edges which are going behind. As a result, they are dotted, they are drawn dotted. So this top plane A1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is visible and the base plane ABCDE is visible only by its outer edge. The backside edges, they are not seen. So this is the way, see, this is the back point. So this point, if you see, there is some change here. I have to make some change here. It is like this. Okay, so now you can see. In fact, what happened is, when we are tilted it like this, and when you see from top, that time, this face, the base is above, and the top is below. So, whatever you are seeing is the base. When you see from here, the base is seen, and the top is not seen. So, as a result, this point is seen. So this point means this point, which is seen. So as I said, this is the base which is seen and this top surface has gone behind when you see from top. Therefore, this will be the correct view, and according to that, these lines will be dotted. Even this line also a dotted line. So that way you will be able to draw this figure. Keep a note of all the various instructions, and this is projections of solids. You have to draw. Another instruction which is already known to you is that when you draw, at that time, the dimensions, whatever dimensions are used here, like the edge of the base, height, whatever angle they are making, etc. So all this information which is shown in the data, that must come here. So this is first problem. Okay, now let us look at the second problem. Now this problem is on pentagonal pyramid. So I'll read the problem here. Pentagonal pyramid with edge of base 50 mm and the height is 100 mm is lying on its triangular face in HP such that the top view of the axis is making 40 degrees with the VP. Draw the projections with the apex away from VP. Now you will see first inclination is not given. Now it is not given because it is already shown to be touching into HP. Now you will see here, this is the triangular face which is supposed to be in HP. Now this triangular face is this line. Now this line we want to bring it to the HP. Therefore this particular front view is tilted in such a way that this line is coinciding with the XY line. So this is the first inclination where the solid is inclined like this. So after this is inclined, this is the revised top view. This becomes the revised top view. So after this revised top view, now the second part of the problem says that the top view of the axis is making 40 degrees with VP. Now this is the top view of the axis. Now this top view itself is going to make 40 degrees with the VP. Now this line XY line is VP. Right now it is parallel. So now we draw this particular axis line at an angle of 40 degrees to the VP. Now you can see here the axis is not fully seen because it is overlapped by the edge. So this edge is covering the axis, and when the two lines are overlapping, we are giving preference to the continuous line over center line. So therefore this is drawn as a continuous line and not as a center line. So that line is here and this is going to make 40 degrees. So this view is repeated here with the reference of this axis at 40 degrees. So now this and these two views are there, and we are having the point names all written over here. We are making the point names A, B, C, D and E such that, and this is O, such that these all the various points are repeated over here. Now having done this, now we are to project the various points, and after you project the points, this becomes the final figure where this is the base. Now this apex is away from VP, therefore this is the position of the pyramid when we draw here, and because it is away, when you are going to see in this direction, apex is towards you and the base has gone away from you, so these lines of the base, they are not seen, they are behind. Now suppose this is on this side, then the base would have been seen and apex would have been on the back side. So this is the final view. Make a note of the figure. Okay, so having done this, now this particular figure is over. We have drawn the pentagonal pyramid and as per the given view. Now as usual, as what was discussed earlier, all the dimensions which are shown in the data, they should all come here. So that the figure then becomes complete figure. You have to also write XY line also in the figure.